So today we're going to be making some leggings out of some brain tan smoked deer hides that I've made, a couple of them. So these are going to be the full length with the fringe on the side. What you need to do is measure the girth of your leg at the highest point right at your crotch across around and down at your ankle. I'm going to cut mine at 25 inches on my thigh, and then at the ankle it'll be 9.5 or 9 or something like that, and then I taper it. It'll go at a tapered from 25 to 9, but you can make it however you like. This is one I cut out of one deer hide, brain tanned and smoked. So I just stitched it along here, and the way you hide the stitch, you just put it down in here like this. And this is all going to be fringed down through here. I'll cut that. Got to trim out this top piece. This would be the inner thigh. This would be the outer thigh. So it'll come at an angle like this, because it needs to be a little longer on the outside than it does the inside. Mule deer, so probably bigger than a whitetail that you would get back east. So if you wanted to make a pair of these leggings, these are full length leggings. Eastern woodland Indians used like 3/4 or just above the knee leggings, but these will be up to your hip and they go down. So I need to trim the bottom here too, about right here somewhere. I gotta measure it off, but I got another hide that I'm working on the other leg. This one's a little bigger hide, so it's trimmed up. That's the trim I got off the edges, and it's the same measurements. Now I'm trying to figure out how to. I know that it's 13.25 from here to here, and down here I want it at 9. So you fold this so that your taper's outside and come down to about, I think it's 24 inches or something like that. My inseam is 30 inches, so it actually be down about right here. But this, I just go down 24 inches, measure it. It's 9.25 at 24 inches down. And that is from this top stitch where I started stitching it here. And I go way down. If you notice, I got the holes punched. So I take a hole punch and run it up and down this edge. About a half inch in, about every half inch apart. If you measure it, you can mark it, you can do all that, but I just go down through and do it. I don't bother marking it. It's not even, like you can see a little bit right here. This one's closer than that one is. But it's not precision work, and that's what makes it look so neat. This one's going to have a little hole here, but it's not going to matter that much. What else do I need to tell you? Oh yeah, the fringe will come off this. I'll have to trim this down here. Cut these fringes in. Trim this off. Trim that off. Thank you. probably the hardest part about this is keeping everything straight, laid out straight, and then, you know, not puncturing your thumb when you're keeping your wood underneath straight. Just take your arm, lift this up just a little bit, stick it through, pull it back, kind of cinch it down a little bit, go back the other way with this one. Back this way with this one. Could go all the way back, I guess, doing this, but I don't have enough length on this, and it's not necessary, but it does kind of look good. It was that type of stitching.
I'm ready to cut some fringe, and I got them all sewed up. I cut this strip off across the top on both back and front. We'll have something to tie it to the belt with. This will be on the hip side, and then so now I'm cutting the fringe. Made a little slight mark, as you can see right here, and so basically just cut down that line. See if I can show you how to do it. I do that.
So you want them to go straight at a 90 degree angle to this line. That way it keeps these about the same width. So if you can, just slice them down through here. I try to go about a quarter inch or so. And if you start going where they're, you know, off angle, if you're off angle this way, say you're cutting it down this way and you realize, hey, I'm getting too far that way, just cut these a little wider, up to 3/8 of an inch or something like that, and make it thinner at the top. But if you go this way, if you need to cut them thinner at the bottom and make them wider at the top. That way it evens out. But it's better just to kind of keep an eye on it as you go. And just try to keep it straight as possible. Certainly helps when you have a nice sharp pair of scissors. A little short pair like this is really good. Makes it go a lot faster. Less work. You ain't having to fight the scissors and works pretty smooth. See, like then I put a little bit of a curve in that one, so I'm gonna go just a little wide on this side. Maybe a little thin in the middle. Straighten it back out.